How are you today?
Good.
Are you ready for a great performance?
Yes.
The kindergarten classes have been working very hard on their performance. I know first grade has already done their year performance, and second grade did theirs, and now it's time for kindergarten. And their performance is called The Little Engine That Could. Can you think of what character trait maybe The Little Engine That Could is going to display? What character trait? What do you think? Endurance? Do you think maybe we'll see something about endurance? Oh, that would be amazing, wouldn't it? Well, today we have Mrs. Grobner, Mrs. Keller, Mrs. Shepherd, and Mrs. Van Heinegen's kindergarten class. They're going to do their version of The Little Engine That Could. And I'm going to turn it over to Mrs. Weaver.
The toys and fruit shouted, "Oh no! Our train is broken. What shall we do? We need another engine to push us over the mountain. The train watched, listened, and waited for help. Clickety-clack, there was a sound on the tracks, the sound of an approaching engine. Was shiny new engine all silvery and bright. The little toy clown was hopeful, and the wheels on Happy Train wiggled and jiggled with happy anticipation. The clown waved a red flag, and the engine's glistening wheels came to a stop. "Why are you stopping me?" complained shiny new engine. Just brushed a speck of dirt off its smokestack and laughed a not so nice laugh. Disappointed, and shiny new engine clickety clacked away. Everyone on the train watched, listened, and waited again for help. After a while, there was the squeaky sound of an approaching engine. Was rusty, crusty engine. The toy clown saw that the engine looked a little broken and slow, but was still hopeful that the engine would help. The wheels on Happy Train wiggled and jiggled in happy anticipation. The clown waved the red flag, and rusty, crusty engine creaked to a stop. "Problem?" the rusty engine creakily asked. It just moaned and groaned, sniffled and snorted.
My smokestack is crusty. I think I can go.
Slowly, the engine creaked and squeaked away and sneezed a big, dusty, choo-choo. Everyone on Happy Train. Again, they watched, listened, and waited for help. After a while, they heard a very loud noise on the track. Coming toward them was a powerful freight train. The hopeful toy clown waved the red flag, and the wheels on the happy train wiggled and jiggled with happy anticipation.
Big important train hissed and stopped.
"Why did you stop me?" it steamed. Engine huffed and puffed out gritty clouds of gray smoke. Freight engine pounded away. The toys, the clowns, and the food were very worried that no engine would help push them over the mountain. They knew that all the boys and girls on the other side of the mountain were waiting for them. Then, in the distance, there was a new sound on the track. A very small, cheerful sound. The toy clown said, "That engine is way too small to push us over the mountain." The clown didn't even wave the red flag for the engine to stop. But that little engine stopped anyway. "Is something wrong?" asked little engine. "Our engine is broken," said the clown. "We are hoping that a big engine will come and push us over the mountain." "I am not big," said little engine. "But I will try to push you. Sometimes, when I need a lot of power, I sing a special song to make me stronger. It goes like this.
I
We don't think you can do it, said everyone on the train, but you can try. Little Engine slowly connected with Happy Train. It pushed and pushed and pushed. Slowly, as they moved up the mountain, Little Engine said, I need more power. Please, everybody, sing the song with me. Mountain, Little Engine pushed Happy Train up to the very top, and then down, down the mountain they easily chugged. There were the children waiting for them in the village station. Happy Train was very happy to be there. The toys were very, very happy, and the apples, pears, bananas, and peaches were so happy they cried sweet fruit juice tears. Everyone shouted, hooray, hooray for the brave little engine that could sing us over the mountain.